My name is Abby McDonald, and I write contemporary realistic fiction for young adults, usually sort of fun coming-of-age stories about friendship with a touch of romance. My latest book is Getting Over Garrett Delaney. It is about a teenage girl called Sadie who has been deeply in unrequited love with her male best friend for years, and she finally has enough of being ignored and decides this is going to be the summer that she finally gets over him. And so she gets a new job in a local coffee shop and comes up with a 12-step program to get over her crush, and sort of with the help of all of her new co-workers and this sort of motley crew of new friends, she finds out who she is without this boy in her life. They're standalones, but what I do is they all take place in the same pop culture fake universe. So I learned with Sophomore Switch, my debut, I made a reference to Chris Brown being really dreamy, and then 2 weeks later he had the incident where he proved himself not so dreamy. And I got in touch with my editors, I was like, can we stop it? Can we stop it? And they said, no, but we'll change it for the second edition. And so since then, I try not to use real pop culture people and names and events because that can come back to haunt you. So what I do is I invent band names and I invent celebrities, and there's like that kind of crossover in the background. So if you pay attention, you'll see them there. And I think that's a really fun Easter egg for a reader to know the same references pop up from book to book. Right. And saves me some trouble of the Chris Brown experience. Well, it was just my first book. My agent happened to know an editor there, Liz Bicknell, and she was an American, she was an English woman living in America. And the book is about a girl from Oxford University and a girl from UC Santa Barbara who trade places for a semester abroad. And so my agent knew that Liz would really love it being a Brit in America. And so they bought it over the weekend on a preempt, and they've bought all of my successive books for YA ever since. And I also write adult novels, which have been published in America by Sourcebooks. I think it is accepting that your first book is gonna suck, and that's okay. And I know a lot of writers who will spend years and years polishing and refining this first great book of theirs, when really the best thing for them as a writer to learn the craft would be to let it go and to write the next book and the next book. You know, like my first book is in a drawer somewhere and it deserves to stay there for a really long time. And I didn't even sell my second, you know, it was my third before I finally got through. And you know, that's what writing is about. It's a craft that you learn and you grow and you get feedback. And it's always about getting better, you know? So.